bright round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night,
thanks, love. Well, here's to having you home. And may the new year bring us all back together again.
They had a good day, didn't they?
I don't think Andrew will run away from home again in a hurry.
Mum, I'm sorry I've put you through such a rough time.
It's all over and done with. I just thank God Andrew and Emma didn't have to go into a home.
Police, Mrs. O'Connell, we have a search warrant.
What's all this about? Can't you leave us in peace?
Your son's escaped from prison. We think he may be here.
G'day, Lizzie. You're really getting yourself into the spirit of things, aren't you?
Yeah, I really love Christmas carols. They make me feel all religious or something.
Here, wait a minute, listen.
Police and prison authorities report that their switchboards have been jammed with phone calls about supposed sightings ever since his escape from jail last night. Police have been following up all leads and believe O'Connell to be still within the metropolitan area. O'Connell is described as being 5'7", of slight build, with brown hair. He is believed to be armed and dangerous.
Oh, armed and dangerous. Bull. Poor old Pat, she'll be worried, silly.
Well, this she'll have her dying little son back. That's what she wanted all along, isn't it?
Oh, wake up to yourself. You know, I'm getting sick and tired of you.
That'd be the worst thing he could do if he came home. Pat could be had up for harbouring.
Yeah. Having a mother's meeting, are we?
Oh, good morning, Miss Bennett.
Go to your own cell and get dressed, Birdsworth, and hurry up about it. And you hurry up as well.
Excuse me, Miss Bennett.
What is it?
I was wondering if I might move in with Ros and B, seeing that Pat's gone now.
No, you can't. Now get a move on.
Water hot?
Hmm.
Would you like some more coffee?
Yes, please.
Did you see this? It's a Chrissy present.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
It's not that good. A bit cheap, I suppose. But it was a nice thought, wasn't it?
Hmm.
John Mooney gave it to me.
Pardon?
John Mooney, the young boy who works with the builder. He's asked me out a couple of times and he's nice enough, I suppose, but oh, I don't know. Maybe a bit later. Did your mate write that?
Who?
You know, Alex, what's his name?
No, he doesn't write these sort of articles.
Please, there's no point in keeping on at me.
Well, can you just tell us if you've heard from your son?
Of course not.
Well, do you expect to?
Why should I?
Well, he's sure to want help, isn't he?
Please, there's nothing more I can say.
Oh, come on, Mrs. O'Connell.
I can't help you. Persistent, aren't they?
They drive you mad. They're even round the back now.
I'll kill them. Look, I've just about had enough of you guys. What do you mean?
I'm a mate of Dave's.
What?
I'm a mate of Dave's. I said Jasmine. He wants to see you.
Are you out of your head? There's reporters all over the place.
Yeah, I see him. Look, missus, he wants to see you. I'll meet you at the corner of Lawrence Street in half an hour. I'll take you where he is, all right?
How do I know this isn't a trap?
Break it down, missus. Look, he reckons if you don't come, he'll come here.
Oh, no.
That's what he reckons.
Well, I'll think about it.
Yeah, I'll be waiting. Half an hour.
You're not going to get a lot of mileage here, old son.
Who was it?
Hey?
At the back door, who was it?
Just another reporter.
There's not much privacy these days, is there? I'd like to know who they reckon they are. It's a good thing the kids are next door, that's all I can say, all this fuss. Not much of a Christmas for them, is it?
No. Oh, those wretched reporters.
Well, I've had a bellyful. I'm going out and tell them all where they can get off. Clear off! Go on, clear off! Get off my veranda, the lot of you! Don't you go taking pictures of me! If you've got any sense, you'll keep on running.
Look, you can get into a lot of trouble doing things like that.
Me? This is my house. I'll do as I like.
Look, you just can't
get... That does it.
Mrs. Devlin, you remember me. I'm Alex Fraser.
My word, I do. And never want to see your stupid face around my house again.
But I just want to talk to Mrs. O'Connell for a minute.
Now, if you don't get off my property, I'll turn the hose on you.
Look, I'll call back later.
Don't bother. Now buzz off, all of you.
Look, take it easy. There's no way she's going to turn it.
And don't come back. There's plenty more where that came from.
Oh, settle down, will you? Look, we're as safe as houses here.
Oh, I don't know. The place doesn't seem safe to me.
Yeah, might fall down. But still, the cops won't find you. It's cool. But it's a good thing you got in contact with me, you know. You always needed looking after. That's your trouble. Even at school, you needed looking
after. Oh, shut
up, Shane! Hey, you all right? No need to get snaky.
I'm not snaky!
Oh, Jesus, Herbie!
I got her.
Yeah, I can see, can't I?
Oh, Dave, love.
You want to sit down? It's not much. It's better than jail, though.
Is it?
Well, not much.
Oh, Dave. Davey, you've got to surrender.
No, Mum.
Listen, love. I know what it's like inside, and I know how hard it's been for you, but... Well, look at yourself. Look at this. Do you want to live like this for the rest of your life, on the run all the time?
Of course not.
Then you've got to give yourself up. It's the only thing you can do.
Mum, please.
I'll catch up with you sooner or later.
No, you don't know what it's like in there.
And what are you doing hanging around with that Shane Berkeley? It's his fault you ever got into jail in the first place.
How is it?
He was always getting you into trouble when you were kids.
He's me mate, Mum. He's helping me.
Oh, great help. He is. I'm warning you, David. And don't you go coming round to Gran's place either. Because I'll put you in. Honest, I will.
Oh, Mum. You know I'd never do that. You've got to be out to look after Andy and Emma.
Promise me you'll give yourself up, David. Please.
Might be for the best. We would, love, for sure. I'll think about it.
If that's not bad enough, she goes and turns the hose on us. Oh, it's not that funny.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, I don't suppose it is. I just wish I'd seen it.
Well, I suppose it is funny if you think about it.
It is, really. Cup of coffee?
Oh, no, thanks. Look, I was wondering, would you mind coming with me? You know, help me get an interview with Mrs. O'Connell?
Oh, I don't think that's a very good idea.
Please.
Well, you may do more harm than good. Try and see it from Pat's point of view. I know your intentions are good, but any publicity at this stage would probably be used against her.
If I can get the right angle, I know I can make the readers understand why he escaped. It's only natural for families to want to be together at this time of the year. Everyone knows that, and they all agree with it. It's just that, in a case like this, you have to remind them, pull on the heartstrings a bit. Look, take this article here. Anyone reading that's going to pass them both off as hardened crims. Who's going to read between the lines? That's why we've got to get Pat's and David's side of the story.
Yeah. All right. You win. Ever thought about going into politics?
Oh, look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go off on
you. It's okay. I just hope I'm doing the right thing, that's all.
That was a real beauty when he said that, Roz. You should have seen the look on Vera's face. It was worth a medal. You're real clever. What are you doing that for?
Yeah, have you read this article about young David O'Connell? Huh? Well, this bloke tries to make it that he's a hired killer or something.
No, I never read that. Oh, Roz, you've got no need to do that.
He's going to have every trigger-happy cop in the state trying to shoot this poor kid down and ask questions later. It's ridiculous.
Oh, hey, B!
Trying to make it his most dangerous criminal ever escaped from jail. Oh. Hey, what are you doing? Roz?
Oh, she's torn up the scripts and everything. Oh, Roz, shouldn't have done that. We could have used them next year.
Why?
Well, we just could have.
What's the point? Wouldn't make a scrap of difference. We could have written Hamlet for the play this year and the screws wouldn't have noticed. Wouldn't have changed a thing.
What are you talking about?
You and you. Oh, you all talk big and tough. But what do you do? Nothing. The screws still walk all over us. So there's no point, is there?
Now, you listen to me, kid. We all wanted that show to get up their noses. We all wanted to make them squirm. But they didn't. Tough. That just means we have to try harder next time. Meanwhile, you'll just have to learn how to live with it like the rest of us, or else.
I'm real scared, Bea.
What you're heading for, kid, is a good swift kick up the backside.
What a crummy Christmas. I mean, it wasn't really very happy, was it? Even me present from me little mate got confiscated because of that bitch Vera. There's no need to confiscate that. It was only a fruitcake.
Knock it off, you mean. Huh? Well, you don't think she threw it in the bin, do you?
Bloody bitch! She's probably eating it now. I'm going to give her a piece of my mind.
Not too big a piece, Lizzie.
What should I do with these, Vera?
What are they?
Oh, I just left over decorations.
They'd better go back to Mrs. Davidson's office.
Right.
Would you like a piece of Christmas cake?
Oh, no thanks. I'm dieting before Christmas. Always eat too much on the day.
You dare eat my cake.
What?
You! Oh, I knew you'd stolen my present for yourself. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Birdsworth, what are you doing in here?
That! My cake that Doreen made me.
You stupid old woman. That cake that Anderson sent you in was so laced with alcohol that you both would have been charged with smuggling in contraband.
Grog.
That's why it was confiscated. Now kindly get out.
Don't seem fair.
This isn't your cake, Lizzie. Now get out before I think of something to charge you with.
Hi. How are you? Not bad.
You don't sound very happy.
Oh, I'm just bored silly, that's all.
Welcome to the club. That's why they don't have capital punishment no more. They just bore you to death. Unless, of course, you can get out.
Yeah.
But then when you get out, that's different again.
David O'Connell got out. Did you read about that?
Yeah.
Do you think he'll stay out?
Who knows? Not so easy for the blokes.
Rubbish. Have you ever tried to escape?
Don't be silly. I'd look real good, wouldn't I, going over a wall in my condition?
No, I meant before you got pregnant.
Nah. Never tried it. Thought about it, though.
About what you said about not being so easy for men.
Mm.
I don't think that's right. When I got out, I had nowhere to go. And that's the most important thing. No, I think David O'Connell will be all right. His family will help him.
Pat, you mean? He'd be bloody stupid to go there. That's the first place the cops would look. No, you can't rely on no one. You're on your own. You gotta be. And you gotta plan it right down to the last detail before you even get out. Otherwise, you haven't got a hope in hell.
I've no idea where he is. I mean, he's hardly likely to come here, is he? He's not stupid.
Mrs. O'Connell, I wish I could make you understand.
I know you're only trying to help, but you can't.
I'm sure I could.
Look, please don't think I'm not grateful. That article you wrote about us in the paper, I think it helped with my parole, and I thank you for that. But this is different. After what they said about us in that other paper, well, any publicity is bad for us. It's bad for the kids and bad for David and bad for me.
I think we'd better go, Alex. I'm sorry if we've upset you, Pat.
Oh, no, you haven't. Look, Mr. Fraser, I reckon he'll give himself up. I think he's got enough sense for that, and when he does, well, maybe then we can write something, eh?
Yes, well, thanks for your time.
I'll see you again very soon. Bye, Pat.
Bye.
Is that you know exactly where you're going. And keep away from your friends, because that's the first place anyone will look.
Well, then, where do you go?
Interstate, of course.
How?
Well, keep away from trains and stuff. Best thing is to meet up with a sailor. You know, on the freighters.
And how would I do that?
Hang about the wharves, of course. Plenty of sailors. They're always looking for a bit.
What? You mean...
You have to forget your fancy morals, Ros. That's why it's easier for women to get away more than blokes. And the cops, well, they never... Well, hardly never check on the freighters.
Yeah, but... I couldn't.
Please yourself. I've got to go anyway.
Chrissy? Could we talk again tomorrow?
Perhaps. What about? Getting up?
Do you think you could help me?
Maybe. Yeah, I've got a few ideas. It'll cost you, though.
Oh, doesn't look like a maternity ward to me.
I'm just going, Bea. See you tomorrow.
What's that all about?
was a private conversation.
Pretty stupid conversation.
Oh?
You think these walls haven't got ears? Anyone in Wentworth could have heard. And you can't trust Chrissy. I wouldn't trust her with my worst enemy.
What does it matter? As long as she can get me out of here, who cares?
You would, if you had any sense.
You didn't do too good when you was out last time.
Yeah. That was before I learnt you only look after number one.
Hey, what about this? Assault. It doesn't say much for their Christmas spirit, does it? Oh, cheer up, son. You look as though you've got the cares of the world on your shoulder. You ought to be pleased you're in with the big boys now. I know your dad's tickled pink. He was carrying on like a two-bob watch down at the pub last night. Couldn't shut him up.
It's just this... this O'Connell story. It's all hit a dead end, you know?
Huh. You feel bad. Imagine how we feel, eh? Could do with a few leads ourselves. Hey, here's a story. Toy shop, break and enter. Now, there's a good story there. Just think. Some poor bludger down on his luck, no dough, maybe unemployed, needs Chrissy presents for his poor, starving kids. What's he do? Knocks over a toy shop. Lovely story there, mate. Just up your street.
Mightn't be so bad.
Eh?
Well, wouldn't get so many knockbacks on a job like that. But I'm going to stick with this O'Connell story.
Stubborn. Chip of the old block, eh?
Who was it?
I don't know. There wasn't anyone there.
Well, what's that?
Found it on the back doorstep.
What is it?
I don't know.
And whoever it was just ran off and left it.
Well, looks like it.
Well, aren't you going to open it?
It's all right, Mum. Give me a chance, will you?
What's in it?
Looks like presents.
Oh, of course. That's what it'd be. It's from one of those charities or something. They must have read about you in the paper. Oh, lovely. Someone's put a lot of thought into choosing that. Heavens, look at that. That's expensive, I'll bet.
Oh, there's so much here. What'll spoil the kids getting all this? Oh, my God.
Love from David. Oh, brilliant. What's he up to? I'd have given him credit for more brains than that.
He promised me he'd give himself up.
What? You mean you've seen him? Oh, I should have guessed as much. That makes you about as clever as he is.
I just wanted him to surrender.
Oh, there, there. It's all right, love. I know you're only trying to do what's best. If he promised you, then he'll do it. Remember when he was a little bloke? When he made a promise to you then? It was a sacred oath to his mum. Oh, you'll see, love. I'll bet he's walking into some police station right now.
And what do you think it's going to be like if you give yourself up, eh? Eh? You get yourself another 2 years for sure, you'll be sick of it then, I can tell you.
What else am I going to do?
We're going to stay.
How?
Simple, we knock off a car.
We?
Yeah, why not? We're mates, aren't we? Anyway, I just feel like a nice holiday.
Yeah, I like it. It's nice. Good. It's yours then. Sort of down payment, you know what I mean? No worries. Now, how would you go about getting out?
Oh, not here. Not now.
I'll see you later then, Ross.
Yeah, bye. See you.
And where do you think you're going with that?
Back to maternity, where I belong.
Oh, well, that you're not. I'm not going to have little creeps like you knocking off me mate's Christmas presents. Now, hand it over.
Why don't you learn to mind your own business, Bea?
What?
I gave it to her. Now, leave her alone.
See you, Ros.
Well, what are you doing giving away Dorian's Christmas present?
I've got my reasons.
Well, whatever they are, they're not good enough. That meant a lot to Doreen, giving you that perfume.
I don't give a damn about Doreen. Look, do you think Doreen's all I've got to worry about?
You had no right giving that away.
It's mine. I can do what I like with it. I could tip it on the floor if I wanted to. Now let me go.
Poor little Dora. It'd kill her if she found out about that. Scram.
Something's got to be done about that kid.
What?
I don't know, but she's getting to be impossible. If we don't get her out of Chrissy Latham's clutches, she's going to turn into a bloody little monster.
Yeah. Ah, oh, pup.
I'll get it.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm John.
Oh, come in.
Are you going?
Yes, go ahead. You.
Hey.
Hello. Any letters?
No.
How are you?
Oh, not bad.
Good. What you doing?
Writing. You know, a letter.
Oh. Do you want to have lunch? Oh, that's why I come, to see if you want to have lunch.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, you don't have to. I mean, I just thought that you might.
Yeah.
Do you want
to? Oh, I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
All right, good. When you let me know?
Later.
Right. Do you like the bracelet?
Oh, yeah, it's nice. It must have cost a packet.
Oh, you know. I'll see you then, will I?
Yeah.
Right. Bye.
Bye. Well, what am I going to do?
Pardon?
He wants me to have lunch with him.
Oh, does he?
Well, what am I going to do?
What do you mean?
Well, should I or shouldn't I?
Well, it's up to you.
But what am I going to do?
It's up to you. I've got to go and do some shopping.
But aren't you supposed to help me?
I can't, love. These are decisions you've got to make for yourself. Same as I had to. Same as everyone has to.
Yeah, but Lizzie would have told me what to do. She would have known. She would have told me.
Smith and Birdsworth are outside.
Show them in.
Come on, you two. Inside.
Now, what's all this about? Thank you, Miss Bennet. That will be all. Now, well, you see, one at a time, please.
You tell her, B.
Tell me what?
Well, you see, it's about Roz.
What about
Rosalind Coulson.
What about her?
Well, she's acting funny.
Oh, yes, she is. Very funny.
In what way?
Well, she's very bitter, you know, and... Well, we're just worried in case she did something silly.
Like what? It would help if you were a little more specific.
Well, there's nothing to be specific about. It's more an instinctive thing.
Yeah, it's a sort of feeling in your bones.
And we just wondered if you... Well, maybe you get a counsellor or perhaps a priest to talk to her.
Yeah, that's what we thought. If you could get a priest.
I see. Thank you for your concern. Is that all?
Yeah. Well, what about the priest?
I'll see what I can do. I have some business to attend to for the next couple of hours, but I'll see about it when I return.
Thanks.
Yes. Thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Don't give up.
Nothing's happening.
You've got to keep trying. Come on. Move, will you? Got to listen for a little click.
What do you think I'm doing?
All right. Be patient. It's easy once you get the hang of it.
Mm, yeah, sure.
Just so long as you keep practicing, that's all.
You don't say.
Oh, it's no good. I'm sick of it for now. The important thing is that you keep practicing.
There must be an easier way.
Colson, Latham, Birdsworth, come back here.
Come on, I see them. Nice.
Enjoying the holiday? On your feet, the pair of you. You're supposed to be working.
Here we come.
Oh, use your nouse. If the cops get a report on a stolen car, we're going to be done like a dinner, aren't we? What we got to do is just lie low for a while, okay? Then, as soon as things cool off, we're off. You see, doing this job is a bit like being a fighter pilot.
Oh, get out.
That's true. 99% boredom, 1% excitement.
Oh, I find the human interest side of things quite exciting.
It takes all kinds. I had a mate flew Spitfires, World War II. 5.5 years. How much action do you reckon he saw?
How much?
About 25 minutes.
Oh, rubbish.
You can scoff, mate. You can scoff. Well, you bet this'll be boring. If you got it in triplicate, all about Mrs. McGillicuddy's poodle. Hello, desk. Sergeant McGinnis. Yeah? Yeah, just a sec. Right. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, good. Right, yeah. Right, got it. Thanks very much. Thank you.
That didn't sound too boring.
I think you're in, son.
What do you mean?
Stolen car. Two blokes seen driving off in it. One closely resembling the description given of David John O'Connell. I think we got him. Now, what's the matter with you? I've just given you the biggest scoop of the month. We've got the Devlin place staked out. All you've got to do is keep an eye on it and hope they're stupid enough to turn up.
Yeah.
Stuff and put it in the bin.
Yeah, in a minute. Want to play a game?
What?
Let's see who can get the closest.
Oh, right, huh?
What, stones?
No, tins and stuff.
Can you swim?
Not much.
You can fetch it if I chuck you in.
You wouldn't try it.
Oh, you reckon you could beat me, eh?
Maybe. I used to do stuff like this when I was a kid.
What, beat the boys up?
Yeah, that too. No, chuck stones at stuff in the river.
Yeah?
But we didn't used to use beer cans. We used to use lemonade bottles. Used to try and break them.
Huh?
No one ever did, of course. Except once. This girl called Brenda did it, a real beauty. She smashed it to smithereens. Then we all had to give her threepence each. It was pennies in those days. She must have collected 2 and 6.
Anyhow, we all forgot about it then. Until a few weeks later when I went back to have a swim. And I nearly cut my foot off on the glass. See? So you shouldn't chuck stuff in the river.
I never thought about it.
Well, you've got to think about other people, don't you?
Yeah, I suppose you do.
Leave me alone! Well, what did you want to do that for? Why did you want to spoil it?
Sorry.
Leave me alone! You creep!
What? Doreen!
Going someplace, Birdsworth?
Oh, g'day, Miss Bennett.
What have you got there?
Oh, nothing.
Don't give me that. What is it? Come on, hand it over.
Oh!
What's wrong?
Oh, it's this pain in me bladder. I was just taking that specimen down to Dr. Miller.
Well, you might have told me.
Oh, I just did.
Well, there's an awful lot of it. Look at the colour.
I told you I was crooked, didn't I?
Well, by the look of this, you should be in your cell lying down. I'll take it to surgery.
Oh, don't you think the doc should see me?
He won't be in till this afternoon. Do you feel fit enough to work?
No, not really, Miss Bennett.
I wouldn't think so. Report to this afternoon's sick call.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
He doesn't have a ghost of a chance.
I know.
If he gets caught within a square mile of Pat's place, she'll get done for harbouring, right?
Unless they catch him before they actually make contact, she'll have a pretty good case then.
What if they wait till he's in the house before they spring the trap?
You're just assuming that he will go there.
Well, don't you think he will? I'd go myself, except Pat's not going to take a blind bit of notice of anything I have to say. And there's no way Mrs. Devlin's going to let me near the place.
All right, I'll come with you. Oh, Greg.
Hi.
Hi. I've got to go out for a while. Pat O'Connell's in terrible trouble.
Karen, your place is here, not gallivanting around helping second-rate journalists scoop the opposition.
Now, just a minute.
That's not fair, Greg. We've good reason to believe that Pat O'Connell's son's on his way there right now, and that's what the police are waiting for. We've got to get to her and warn her before she ends up back inside.
Which is exactly what will happen to you if you start getting mixed up in it.
We can't just sit here and let it happen. Come on, Alex.
You take one step outside that door, and I'll phone the police. I'm not kidding, Karen.
Hey, Con, what's the time?
Wouldn't have a clue.
He's a bit late, isn't he, the doc?
Yeah, I reckon.
Well, what do you think's holding him up? Oh, wouldn't it rot you?
What's wrong with you?
Oh, nothing. You wouldn't want to change places with me, would you?
No way.
I'll make it worth your while.
Yeah?
All right.
You're on. All right, who's first? Hang on just a minute.
What's wrong?
Me appendix, I think it's burst.
Oh, God, that's all I know. Give me a hand, you two.
Oh, you little beauty.
You, Greg, you're perfectly happy to just sit there and let Pat go back to jail for harbouring.
I simply don't want to see you going back to jail, that's all. Besides, if the situation's as desperate as you say it is, I doubt there's anything anyone can do at this stage.
We can't just sit here and let it happen.
It's going to happen whatever we do.
And that solves your conscience, does it? Well, it's not good enough for me. Not good enough at all.
I think Dr. Miller's right, Karen.
Do you just?
Yes.
It's big of you, Mr. Fraser. What about your story?
Look, Doctor, I don't deny that this story could, well, could set me up for good. But honestly, I'm far more interested in Karen and Pat.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Well, glad to see that you two have solved the world's problems.
Oh, you're being unreasonable, Karen.
Am I? Look, I don't care what either of you say. I'm going.
Karen!
And you can call the police. I don't care.
All right. If it's so damned important to you, I'll go. I must be crazy.
I don't like it. I just don't like it.
Looks clear to me.
Oh, they're not going to advertise themselves, are they?
I suppose not.
Bloody stupid idea, this. Why can't you just write a letter like any normal person?
Look, it'll only take a minute. I just got to tell her why I'm not going to give myself up. Geez, I might not see her again for years.
Yeah, you're bloody mad. And I need my head read. Look, you keep the motor running and I'll go and get her. And if the cops come before I get back, cover me with this, okay?
But I'm no good with guns.
Well, you better bloody well learn, eh?
Shane, what are you doing here?
It's Dave. He wants you.
Well, I can't come now. What if the cops are watching?
No, he's just over there.
He must be mad. Who is it? Who's he?
Oh, come on, Mrs. O'Connor. We ain't got much time.
What is it? It's David, isn't it? Oh, Pat, you can't go, love. You can't. What about the kids? I can't look after them with my legs. You want them to end up in a home? Oh, Mum, boy, that's where they're going to end up if you get caught with David. You'll do your parole. You'll go back inside. They won't let me keep them in my condition.
Oh, I know, Mum, I know. But David's my kid too.
Look, we ain't got much time. We're shooting through.
What? Where?
Well, me and Dave to New South.
But he promised. He said he'd give himself up.
He never said nothing about that, but he reckons he ain't going until he sees you.
You can't just run off like that.
Oh, look, I'm not sticking around any longer. Are you coming or not?
But you can't.
I've got to, Mum. I've got to make him surrender.
Oh, we're not giving in, Missus.
He's got to give himself up.
Pat! Pat, oh, please, love! Patricia, you come back here at once! Pat!
Pat, go back! It's a trap! The police know David's here! Get off the street!
Cheer up, Karen. Look, he wanted to go. Besides, what could happen? Everything will be all right.
He didn't want to go, you know.
Jean, what's wrong?
Just a hand, the latest news on the O'Connell manhunt. The details are sketchy so far, but there was a gunfight when O'Connell was trapped by police while trying to visit his mother. Police called on him to surrender, but he started shooting. It's understood that at least two people are dead. One policeman has been wounded and another killed. A man believed to be an innocent bystander has also been killed. O'Connell's whereabouts are not presently known.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing.